Oh, my goodness, Harold, look. That man's riding an ostrich.
It's all right, Ethel. You can look. That ain't nothing but a Republic ATRT.
Hey, I'm John. Thanks for joining me for this video today. Now, if you're not familiar with the ATRT, it's basically a little scout walker that originally appeared, if I recall correctly, in the Clone Wars animated series and was used by the Republic as a scout, an attack vehicle, various things like that. It just had one rider on it, and they would run around and shoot things and do Star Wars stuff. The Walker originally came out with the core Legions set, Star Wars Legions set from Fantasy Flight Games, and had a Rebel Trooper on it. The idea being that later on the Rebels would use some of these Walkers in their fight against the Empire, but it has its roots back in the Republic. And so this one actually has a Clone Trooper on it. Now, I've gone ahead and assembled the legs and the main body of the walker. This is a separate piece of armor here, and then you have the weapons. You can see the parts breakdown here, and it's interesting because I built the Rebel version of the ATRT back when I was blogging, and it came pretty much assembled. You only had to put the legs on and a few other pieces. This one, everything is in pieces, and these instructions aren't real helpful in terms of assembly. You kind of have to just test fit everything and figure it out. I did find out after assembling this whole thing that there are PDF instructions available on their website, so I'll put a link down below in the description for those. So if you build this, it'll make it much easier. But you have an option of two different riders. One has this kind of hood helmet on, and then this other one has a slightly different, more Empire-ish looking helmet. I'm not sure which one I'm going to build yet, because they have two completely different sets of legs and bodies, so it's not really easy to combine them, because I kind of like the look of this one holding the gun here, but I kind of like the head on this one, and I'm not sure if I'm going to just swap that out or what I'm going to do, but I'll figure that out as the video goes along. Whichever figure I use, I've got to get everything primed first before I can start painting, so that's what I'm going to do next. I needed to get the basic materials added to the base, so I started with just some plain white glue, and then I thinned it with about an equal amount of water, and then using an old brush, I just stirred it together, got it nice and thin, and begin applying it to the base. I didn't really try and be neat about it. I just slopped it on there because I wanted to fully cover the base. And once it was fully covered, I just dropped it right down into some dirt. That's dirt from my backyard. I just sifted it and baked it to make sure it was good and clean. And then I periodically through this process would position the model on the base just to check the spacing for where I wanted to place the rocks, the higher elements, for where the model would stand. These are pieces of cork that I just broke apart with a knife and just into random shapes. I'm not too worried about the glue not being super sticky. As I put this glue on to kind of seal things down, it pushes things around, but that's okay. Those are cork shavings that I used to just represent smaller rocks that have broken off, or maybe a rock has, you know, been stepped on and crushed or something like that. And again, you see, I just positioned the model to see where I'm going to be able to add more of the basing material. And again, I went in with some more of my glue, put in another piece of cork, and followed the same process. I put the glue around the edges of all of this material to make sure that I sealed it in good. I put it over the top. Here's more of the shavings that I put on. And the glue, it takes quite a while to dry. I'll actually need to give this about 2 days to really get good and dry. But once it's done, I'll be able to prime this and then later paint it. And it should look like some rocky terrain that the walker is running over. After priming the figures, I gave it a base coat of scale color Arctic blue. The reason I wanted to paint something on here that essentially is almost the same color as the primer is if I have to go back and do later touch-ups, which I know I'm going to have to, I'll have a consistent base color that I can use and not have to try and replicate the primer to touch it up. But I just gave it a good coating all over. Of course, applying this in two or three layers so that it goes on smooth and completely covers. Now, the next step that I wanted to do was to paint in that dark undersuit. And I didn't go for pure black here. I went for a German gray because I want to leave some room for some shadowing later on with a darker color. And so I just painted these in kind of like a speeder bike look rather than completely painting that area white like you'd see on most clone troopers. I kind of made an editorial decision to treat him more like a speeder bike rider and paint those areas black. Now, I didn't try to get all of the gaps in the armor. I was going to let a wash do that, but this is just painting the major areas. Some of them are a little difficult to get to, but I'm not going to worry about it because once I get these black areas painted in, I can go back with that base color and fill in any areas where I made mistakes. That's the reason I wanted to use a consistent base color rather than just leave it in the primer color. So when I had to go back and make touch-ups like this, it would blend in really well and I didn't have to worry about did I match the primer color exactly. I knew I could just go back to that one color and it would work really well for me. For the shade, I used a mix that I'd seen Mark Sarastro use. One part Black Templar, three parts Apothecary White contrast paints, and then I thinned this down with three parts Contrast Technical Medium and one drop of Flow-Aid to just help it flow around on the model. And I didn't try to be neat. I just covered in sections. I just covered everything on the model. I wanted to make sure to get the recesses, but I wanted to get everything else too so that it would darken it down equally. And then I just went back into the flatter areas and just cleaned up the excess wash that had gotten across the model so I could go back later and neaten those up. It really brings out all of the detail. It's a dramatic change when you start doing this. And it's really easy to do. You don't have to be real precise about getting it into the gaps. And you're not trying to avoid any of the flat areas. You just cover the whole thing in the wash. Now, for the walker itself, I used a mix of Arctic blue and neutral gray in equal parts. And again, this is just to establish a base color so that if I need to neaten things up later, I have a defined color. But I just painted all over all of the parts, the legs, and the body of the walker itself. Got everything with this color. And then I just went back in with the wash, and as I did before, just covered everything in it. I didn't try and avoid any of the areas. This gives a dirty look. It kind of starts the weathering. It darkens it down a bit, which is exactly what I wanted. And then I just went in again and wicked up any of the excess so that that wouldn't pool up too bad. But I didn't worry if it did because, again, it just kind of starts the weathering process. Now for the rider, I used a mix of three parts cold white and one part sky gray to kind of brighten up that armor, to bring it closer to pure white. I very rarely use pure white to start painting with, but rather build up to it gradually using various shades of very light gray until my final highlight is with pure white. So even though this looks white here, as I add later highlights to it, you'll see that it will make the armor pop a lot more and give it kind of that gloss look that we're used to seeing. So here it is with the lighter gray on, and we still have to add some white to it, but it's looking more and more like a clone trooper here. I switched to Vallejo Cold White to bring up the final highlights. And I like to do this because if you just paint something pure white, you have nowhere else to go in terms of shadows and highlights. So this cold gray, or this cold white, provides a final almost white pop. And I just added this to the areas that would be facing the light and most likely to catch the light. And it just kind of polishes it up, that armor shell that he wears, and gives it a good final look. Top of the helmet is especially one to catch some light, so I made sure to get that well coated. And a few places on the legs, just the upturned surfaces on the legs. On the walker itself, I gave it a dry brush of sky gray just to bring out the details that are all over this model. It's got some great surface details, so I wanted those to pop out a little bit from the work that had already been done. And then I wanted to do some decorative elements that I've seen on photos of this, and I just hand painted these in. It's a mix of green gray and green sky. And I wasn't trying to be too careful about this. With my poor eyesight and my shaky hand and trying to do this around the camera, wouldn't have mattered if I was careful anyway, because it was quite difficult to do. But what I did was just roughed that in at first and basically just got the general shape in there. And then I went back with second coats and just kind of cleaned that up so that it looked, it was fully opaque. And it looked reasonably straight, knowing that I was going to put some chipping on this later and could focus that on any areas that didn't look really good. It looked okay. It's not great, but I didn't really intend for it to be at this point. I also painted some of this mix on a few of the elements on the legs, just again to add a little bit of color to it and to look like some of the pictures that I'd seen in looking at these walkers from the Clone Wars cartoon series. The guns were painted with German gray and natural steel, a one-to-one mix, and I just heavily painted this on with a brush that had obviously seen better days, but it's just flooding this on there. You just want to get the paint on there. And I also used this for the handles of the walker itself that the rider is hanging on to. The seat was painted with whole red, and I just wanted to give that a little bit of a different look. I think the Canon color is black, but I just like to give it a little bit of a leather look, just something a little different that'll make it stand out, even though the rider's going to be covering up most of it. The guns, once dry, were covered with Nuln oil, and this just gave it a little bit of depth into the recesses and the shadows and places like that. I also added a little bit back into the walker itself in some areas that I thought needed some boosting of the shadows, so to speak. Stormhost Silver was used to dry brush the guns just to pop out the edges and make them seem a little more three-dimensional, just give them a little more volume. It's nothing fancy, just a basic base shade and then dry brush, but it works really well. On the base, I covered it with Iraqi sand, and I just thinned this down and brushed it on. It actually, because I thinned it down so that it would flow really well, it took probably 3 to 4 coats to get it up to the color that I wanted. I wasn't real concerned with making it all completely even. If it was a little bit patchy and slightly different colors in places, that was fine. I wasn't too worried about that. And then I set this aside to dry. For the driver, I wanted to give him a little bit of chipping on his armor. So I used some neutral gray just to paint in a few chips here and there, figuring that uniform or that armor would get scuffed when he got off the walker to go around and do whatever combat he was going to do. Then I also added some chips onto the walker itself using sky gray and a sponge. And this just provided some wear and tear to the model. I concentrated most of it around the feet, although I did put more of it up further on the walker itself so that it got on there all over. I concentrated a little more where his feet would be and where the rider's legs would brush up against those side panels there, figuring that would receive some wear and tear. For the instruments, I used Ammo of MIG Warhead Metallic Blue. This is a really punchy, bright metallic blue. And I just use this pretty much for any kind of instrument panel or thing like that, because you can just blob it on and leave it. And once it dries, it catches the light nicely and looks pretty good. I was ready to start gluing things together, so using Tamiya Extra Thin Cement, I glued on that front armor plate, and it just slides right into place. And then I glued on the legs. This actually took a couple of attempts because I just was not able to see what I was doing. They fit perfectly, but you have to get the pegs lined up just right for everything to go in. But once I got it lined up just right, it popped right into place without any problems at all. And it's looking like a walker, I think. I like the look of this little thing. I wanted to add some smoke effects, so I used this Starship Filth from Abtilung 502 Abtilung, sorry. And I just dry brushed on some of these oils there on those vents on the side, figuring that might be some kind of exhaust vent. And I put it on kind of heavily at first, and then I went back later and just used a Q-tip to kind of tone it down a little bit. I also used some Agrax Earthshade just to provide some oil and fluid kind of staining. And I'd filmed more of this, but I suddenly drifted off camera, and well, this is all I ended up having. Then I put some Vallejo model wash, just brown model wash, on the base to bring out some of the recesses. It fills into the recesses, but it pulls away from the higher parts, and I thought it looked pretty cool when that was on there. Then I used some of this Citadel contrast paint, the Apothecary White, to paint the rocks. It lets a little bit of that brown shine through, but it just gives them a look like, well, I thought it ended up looking like a rock, so I was pretty happy with doing that. Then I dry brushed everything with a 50-50 mix of Iraqi sand and sky gray just to bring out the highlights. And I dry brushed the rocks a little bit too so that everything got a coat of it. And we'll just kind of tie it all together to look a little bit dusty and dirty and worn out. And I was pretty happy with how this very simple base came out. All right, I'm ready to call this guy done. Off camera, I put the rider on and put the gun on, glued him to the base, and I just blended in a little bit of, well, blended in sounds a little fancy. I just put on some Vallejo pigments, European earth, and I just brushed him over the feet and down the center of it to look like maybe it was kicking up that area of the ground, and I brushed just a little bit on the rider's feet and lower legs just to look like, you know, when he got off of this thing and walked around, there was going to be dust on it. But I'm pretty happy with how it turned out. If you've not built one of these Fantasy Flight Games Star Wars Legion kits, I think you'd really enjoy one. And again, I don't remember if I've said it in this video. I know I've talked about it before. I don't actually play the game. I just really like Star Wars, and I really like these figures. They're excellent little models. They've got a lot of detail. They're fun to paint. They're fun to weather. They're very affordable, and I think they just look really good. So if you've not looked one up or looked to get one, I'd highly recommend checking them out. I get mine off of Amazon. I get them from a website called miniaturemarket.com, and no, they're not paying me to say this. And then there's a local hobby shop that carries gaming figures and things like that, and they have some of these. And so between one of those three places is where I get mine. So if you've not taken a look at them, I highly recommend doing so. Well, thank you so much for watching this video, and especially if you're still watching at this point. I'm really grateful just to have a little fun. Sometimes I like to have a little fun with the folks who hang around to the end. If you're still watching at this point, why not drop a comment down below that says, "Look out for that ostrich," and we'll know what it is, and we'll laugh, and everybody else that doesn't watch the rest of the video will go, "What are they talking about?" So that would make me laugh. There are links down below to social media that I'm on. There's also, of course, the subscribe link down over here. If you would hit that and hit the bell icon, I would be most grateful. And if you would, whether you're dropping a silly comment or a real comment, I'd be most grateful if you would drop a comment down below and hit the like button. That helps me grow the channel, which I'm trying to do, and I would be most grateful for that. There's also a link down below to Patreon. If you would like to support the work that I do, please check that out. If you're already a Patreon supporter, thank you so much. I am most grateful for the support that you provide. It's a blessing to me, and it's a blessing to my family. And with all that being said, I'll leave you with one final thought, as I always like to do. In this hobby, if you're not having fun, you're doing it wrong. Happy day to you, friends. Bye-bye.